Hey y'all, it's Cheyenne.
What's up y'all, it's TR and we back with another DA Weekly.
Hey TR, they not ready for this one.
I don't know bro, they might just be ready.
I don't even know what you want to pick.
Let's just start off calm with the little gaming segment.
Alright, here is gaming strategies with Logan.
Hello DeAnza, I am the DeAnza Don. Today we are here with
me, Alex.
And we are going to teach you how to win tic-tac-toe and rock-paper-scissors every time.
So Logan, can you explain this game of tic-tac-toe to me?
So basically, tic-tac-toe is a game where you get three of your own symbols in a row.
I see.
If your opponent goes here, you should probably go somewhere around here, right?
Yeah.
It's like opposite of them. Then they'll probably go and try to get a three in a row to win. What you do is you simply block it, right? Yeah. And your opponent is probably going to block it too, right? Block your win, block their win. So basically, then you go right there. And after that, you win. You know why?
Why?
Because look, the second they try to block it, you win. And oppositely, the second they block it, you win. Easy as that. Now, I've explained this game of tic-tac-toe to you guys. We should probably move on to Rochambeau.
And now we're on to Rochambeau. How do you win that?
So basically, and I want everyone at home to try this. What you want to do is put up your hands.
Okay.
Like you're playing Rochambeau.
Okay.
Get back up. Come on. Come on.
Okay. Now, how do you actually win Rochambeau?
So, basically, and don't do what I did before, but now try this. Put up your hands like that.
Okay, we should try this one at home.
And then, basically, what we want to do is...
Ow.
And that is how you beat... everyone in tic-tac-toe and Rochambeau.
Yeah, goodbye, DA. I am the DA Don. And Mike Man.
I'm gonna be beating you in all the tic-tac-toe games now.
Okay, and I'll win in everything else.
You'll never beat me in no game.
Anyways, next segment we have is a confession segment.
Here's Confessions with DeAnza.
Who are we here with today?
Eliza.
AJ.
Peridon.
Emily. Crystal.
Tito.
Elijah Benton.
Sean Williams, a.k.a. Kuro.
Nala Dozier.
AJ.
Elijah, what's your biggest childhood fear?
Probably deep water. I don't know.
Deep water? Like drowning?
No, like big old bodies of water. Like, I don't know.
Probably getting chased by a bee.
Chased by a bee, okay.
Probably like getting lost from my parents in a public setting, like the supermarket or something like that.
Getting stuck in an elevator.
Heights,
like roller coasters.
Heights.
Losing a friend.
Jack the Killer.
Okay. My biggest childhood fear was trees back then. Okay. Stop. Yeah.
Okay. And what's something you haven't told your parents?
I spent $1,000 on my game and told my pops it was a scam.
What game was it?
I don't even know. I think it was Call of Duty.
Okay.
But I got chased by the cops.
You got chased by the cops?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I lost my Buddha chain at the park and I never told them.
Okay.
That I snuck out before? Yeah, we snuck out and then our brothers.
I broke my controller the same day I got it.
Okay, thank you.
That I snuck out the house without their consent.
Okay, thank you.
I put a crack in my mom's phone.
I stole some cookies when I was like 6.
Okay, thank you. Who are we here with today?
Principal Pierce.
And what's your biggest childhood fear?
Ooh. I think as a... product of a single parent, I think potentially losing my mom at a younger age was something I think that I was fearful of.
Okay, and what's something you haven't told your parents?
I haven't told my parents that I have on these nice clothes today.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I hope y'all got everything off your chest.
If you guys want more confessions like this, just let us know. But moving on.
Everybody know at DA we have our very own superstar.
Yeah, I don't think they really know though.
You right.
Here's all about pop star Lily.
Hello, Deanza. It's your host, Francisco, once again, you know, from Grand Man. And today we're here with pop star, the famous queen herself. What's your name?
Aaliyah.
All right, bro. Question number one, Aaliyah. How did you become so famous at Deanza?
It all started in my sophomore year that there was a performance in the rally, and I was thinking that maybe I want to do it, and so I did it, and everyone really liked my dances there.
Okay, sounds amazing. Well, question number two. What do your fans think of you as a pop star?
They think of me as a famous celebrity there. Everywhere at school, everyone was like, oh my God, it's Aaliyah, oh my God.
Oh my God.
Like.
Next question. Will you be performing at any other rallies this year?
Yes, I will. I'll be performing at the Colocho rally, the Multicultural rally, and the Hello Goodbye rally.
Hello Goodbye rally. I'm waiting for that one. Okay, and this is one of the last questions, you know what I'm saying? Can you please hit a dance for us? I will provide you with the song. Okay, just give me 1 second here. Okay, that's that. Okay, you want to say anything else to, you know, your fans out there?
Yes, I will.
Okay.
I want to say to y'all, if you want to be a performer, go ahead. You have every right to chase your dream. Never give up on yourself. Stay true to who you are. If you believe in yourself, you can achieve anything you want it to be. So thank you to all my fans and to all my family who has always supported me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Aaliyah.
That was nice. Now y'all know a little more about our superstar.
But do y'all think y'all can dance like her?
We got one more segment.
My personal favorite.
Here's Baking with the Dimes.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the 7th episode of Baking with the Dons. Today we're going to be making chocolate dipped cream puffs. For this recipe, you will need 2 packages of instant vanilla pudding mix, 2 cups of heavy cream, 1 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of butter, 1 cup of water, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 4 large eggs, and 2 bags of melting chocolate. The first step is to mix together the vanilla pudding mix, milk, and cream. Now, preheat your oven to 425 degrees. In a large pot, bring water and butter to a boil. Stir in the flour and salt until the mixture forms a ball. Transfer the dough into a large mixing bowl. Beat the eggs in 1 at a time, mixing well after each. Drop tablespoons of batter onto an ungreased baking sheet, spacing them a couple inches apart. Bake for 20 to 25 minutes in a preheated oven until golden brown. Center should be dry. When shells are cool, either split them and fill them with the pudding mixture, or use a pastry bag to pipe the pudding into the shells. Now it's time to taste it.
I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Well, y'all, we made it to the end of the video.
Another fire episode.
With good segments, as always.
Let us know what more y'all want to see.
And we'll see y'all next time.
That's a wrap.
We out of here. What? You will never beat me in no game.
What you said last time.
Yeah, but I don't think they really know, though.
Yeah, you right, you right.
Here's... God. Here's all about pop... God. That just sounds, feels so weird. Like, here's everything. God. My God. But introducing the next segment. God.
Rolling. Scene 3, take 8.
You right, you right.
But here's all about pop star Lily.